just two lines, or if I just do a bunch of A's until I come in.
We are the church, the body of our Lord. We are all God's children. We have been restored. The church is not a building where people go to pray. It's not made out of sticks and stones. It's not made out of clay. We are the church, the body of our Lord. We are all God's children. We have been restored. You can go to worship, but you cannot go to church. You can't find a building that's alive, no matter how you search. We are the church, the body of our Lord. We are all God's children. We have been restored. The church is not a business, a committee, or a board. It's not a corporation for the business of the Lord. We are the church, the body of our Lord. We are all God's children, and we have been restored. The church, it is the people living out their lives, called in light and sanctified for the work of Jesus Christ. We are the church, body of our Lord. We are all God's children. We have been restored. Lord, be the music that flows from our hearts. Lord, be the song that we sing. And each day that passes, we pray we'll do our part to give all the glory to the King. Dear Jesus, you have given us our voices and the song. You've given us the talents that we share. And as we join together and others sing along, you give the opportunity to care. So Lord, be the music that flows from our hearts. Lord, be the song that we sing. And each day that passes, we'll pray we'll do our part to give all the glory to the King. Through you we have the talents. Through you we have the song. Through you we hear the melody above. And as we join together and others sing along, we're joining in the power of God's love. So Lord, be the music that flows from our hearts. Lord, be the song that we sing. And each day that passes, we pray we'll do our part to give all the glory to the King. Lord of justice, Lord of life, help us to do what you know is right. Oh, Lord of justice. justice, Lord of life, guide us through the day and night. To the stranger may we give welcome, to the hungry may we give bread. To the naked may we give clothing, to the homeless a place to lay their head. Lord of justice, Lord of life, help us to do what you know is right. Oh, Lord of justice, Lord of life, guide us through the day and night. To the wounded may we give healing, to the voiceless may we give words. To the captives may we give freedom, to the tortured release from all the hurt. Lord of justice, Lord of life, help us to do what you know is right. Oh, Lord of justice, Lord of life, guide us through the day and night. Come join the journey of Jesus today. Love is the light that will show us the way. And like the trees bearing good fruit, we will bring forth Jesus' love. Come join the journey of Jesus today. Joy in the Spirit will brighten our way. And like the trees bearing good fruit, we will bring forth Jesus' joy. Come join the journey of Jesus today. Peace is the promise for us to proclaim. And like the trees bearing good fruit, we will bring forth Jesus' peace. Come join the journey of Jesus today. Love is the light that will show us the way. And like the trees bearing good fruit, we will bring forth Jesus' love. We will bring forth Jesus' love.
Good morning. Good morning. Welcome to worship this morning. As we gather together, we give thanks to God for the gift of this beautiful day and all that we receive by God's generous hand. Will you please stand? We're going to sing our gathering song number 674 in the Blue Book, but we're going to sing verses 1, 4, and 5 only.
Splendor of land, heaven.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us pray. You are the treasured people of the Lord,
a people holy to the Lord our God.
Keep the words of the Lord in your heart and teach them to your children. Talk about them when you are at home and when you are away, when you lie down and when you rise. One does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of the Lord. Will you please join in singing To God Be the Glory? You may be seated. Lord be with you.
And with you.
Let us pray. Loving God, you have made it known to us that if we live, we live for you. And if we die, we die for you. Whether we live or whether we die, we are yours. Keep us open to your love and healing so that we may be that to and for others. Amen.
Our first reading comes from 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. A reader from 1 Thessalonians. But we do not want you to be uninformed, brothers and sisters, about those who have died, so that you may not grieve as others do who have no hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, through Jesus, God will bring with him those who have died. For this we declare to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will by no means precede those who have died. For the Lord himself, with the cry of command, with the archangel's call, and with the sound of God's trumpet, will descend from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up in the clouds together with them to meet the Lord in the air. And so we will be with the Lord forever. Therefore, encourage one another with these words. The word of our Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our second reading is from Revelations chapter 21. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them. They will be his peoples, and God himself will be with them. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more, for the first things have passed away." And the one who was seated on the throne said, "See, I am making all things new." Also he said, "Write this, for these words are trustworthy and true." Then he said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty I will give water as a gift from the spring of the water of life." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand. The Holy Gospel according to the book of John, the 11th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Now a certain man was ill, Lazarus of Bethany, the village of Mary and her sister Martha. Mary was the one who anointed the Lord with perfume and wiped his feet with her hair. Her brother Lazarus was ill. So the sisters sent a message to Jesus, "Lord, he whom you love is ill." But when Jesus heard it, he said, "This illness does not lead to death. Rather, it is for God's glory, so that the Son of Man may be glorified through it." When Jesus arrived, he found that Lazarus had already been in the tomb 4 days. Now, Bethany was near Jerusalem, some 2 miles away, and many of the Jews had come to Mary and Martha to console them about their brother. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went and met him, while Mary stayed at home. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now, I know that God will give you whatever you ask of him." And Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise again." Martha said to him, "I know that he will rise again in the resurrection on the last day." Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live, and everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" She said to him, "Yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Messiah, the Son of God, the one coming into the world." When Mary came where Jesus was and saw him, she knelt at his feet and said to him, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died." When Jesus saw her weeping and the Jews who came with her also weeping, he was greatly disturbed in spirit and deeply moved. He said, "Where have you laid him?" And they said to him, "Lord, come and see." Jesus began to weep. So the Jews said, "See how he loved him." But some of them said, could not he who opened the eyes of the blind man have kept this man from dying? Then Jesus, again greatly disturbed, came to the tomb. It was a cave, and a stone was lying against it. Jesus said, take away the stone. Martha, the sister of the dead man, said to him, Lord, already there is a stench because he has been dead for 4 days. Jesus said to her, did I not tell you that if you believed, you would see the glory of God? So they took away the stone. And Jesus looked upward and said, Father, I thank you for having heard me. I know that you always hear me, but I have said this for the sake of the crowd standing here, so that they may believe that you sent me. When he said this, he cried with a loud voice, Lazarus, come out. The dead man came out, his hands and feet bound with strips of cloth and his face wrapped in a cloth. Jesus said to them, unbind him and let him go. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Please be seated. Well, Maya, I love when you're here. And I just think that those glasses make you so cute. You don't have to come up here. It's fine. But I will give you a treat if you want. That's only fair. Because here I am talking about you, and you didn't ask for that this morning. Excuse me? Can we help you? Hey, lady, are you lost?
No, I think I'm right where I'm supposed to be. I'm an angel, as you can see, and I've never been in church before.
I'm sorry to tell you this, but you really aren't an angel.
Sure I am. Oh, by the way, somebody gave this to me. They said you might know what to do with it. Anyway, it says right here in my job description that I'm in. Yeah, it says angel heavenly. Representation of a spiritual entity.
Oh, I get it. So you're a make-believe angel, like those that we see on TV and movies and hear about in songs. So, because you don't look anything like what the Bible says you should. In Ezekiel chapter 1, verses 5 through 9, it describes a person not even a person, it's something that looks like a big wheel, and it's got lots of eyes, and it's not really nice looking. At all.
I don't look anything like that, do I?
No, you don't. So I think maybe you're not an angel. But what makes you think you became an angel?
Oh, I died and went to heaven.
That's not how this works. Okay, first, when they die, our loved ones wait for the day when Jesus returns, when we will all join Jesus together in the new heaven and the new earth. Technical difficulties. Well, and second, we don't need to think of angels for comfort with all that God has already got waiting for us, and we know that because we believe in what Jesus said. And besides that, God created all the angels that will ever exist, and nowhere in the Bible does it mention God making more angels.
No new angels?
No. I have a question, though. What do you think angels are supposed to do?
Oh, we're supposed to be loved, worshipped, and adored.
No. Sorry. Angels are God's messengers. And God can and does send them to watch over us if that's what God wants to do, to guide us and protect us. We know that God does all of those things for us, maybe through an angel that looks like, you know, like any of our neighbors here, or, you know, maybe when we pray to Jesus and Jesus says, maybe, you know, try this instead of that. We've already done the wrong thing. Let's do the right thing. But the Bible doesn't say anything about there being any personal guardian angels. And there aren't, and angels aren't magical, and they do have limits. And as far as love and worship and adoration, angels give all of that to God.
So, if I'm not supposed to be a guardian angel, and I'm not supposed to be worshipped and adored, what am I supposed to do? Sing?
Yes. Yes, actually, you are supposed to sing. Maybe you should consider another line of work. Let's see. Maybe different kind of gown, or, you know, with, we take this off a little maybe and take those, you could change your angel wings out for some other kind of wings. We'll put those there. And look. We'll give you a wand instead. And now you are a great, fine fairy godmother.
I can do that. I gotta go see Cinderella. I'll be back in a little while.
I love that. She's so clever. We've heard that before, this whole thing about angels, and we have these ideas in our head of what angels are supposed to be and what they do and how they work in the world and how they work in heaven. And if you look on the back of, or the one on your insert, there's a little picture of a, and it's very little, there's a bigger picture on the bulletin board, of a biblical description of an angel. And it doesn't really look like our imagination, or the angels from our imagination, or that we have seen in movies or on television or read about in books. Angels are scary. Heavenly angels are scary. And practically every time they show up in the Bible, they say, "Do not be afraid." Because they're scary. I mean, even if they did take on human form, they wouldn't look like you and me. I would guess that they would be glowing and have features that we'd never seen before. But of course, all of that is imagination too, because it never says anything like that in the Bible. God must have needed another angel. So he took your loved one, your child, your baby, your mom or dad or uncle or spouse. God must have needed another angel, so he took yours. If you listen really carefully and you go back and you read the scriptures, all of them that were read today, Arlene and I, there's practically nothing in there that indicate that God is all about taking people, taking life. God is about giving life. Giving life here in this place, and giving life everlasting in the new heavens and in the new earth that the Revelation talks about. God makes all things new. See, the home of God is with the people, with mortals, and he will dwell with them. He will live with them, and they will be his people, and God himself will be with us, and he will wipe away every tear from our eyes. This does not sound like a God who decides on whatever particular day it is, ending with a Y, that your loved one needs to be plucked up out of this earth and taken away because he needed another angel. God gives life. God doesn't take life. I was talking with my family yesterday. Josh and my sister Marge were having a great conversation about all sorts of different things. And Sarah, maybe all of us were there, I don't know. About all of the things that people say you should or shouldn't eat, or should or shouldn't do to save your own life. Like, my sister's son-in-law is about making sure that nobody is drinking diet pop in his house because of the artificial sweetener, and it's gonna kill you. Well, if all you ever drink is artificial sweetener, then your body's not going to like you very much. But it would take a lot of artificial sweetener to actually shut down your organs. You got to drink water. You got to wash the stuff out, you know? It used to be where you shouldn't drink coffee because caffeine is bad for you, but now caffeine is good for you because it's good for your heart. Or you're not supposed to pick a thing. So many things that we've heard in our lifetimes that somebody did a field of research and discovered this happens in mice. And if you read the whole story, they left out the part where you would have to inject yourself with this certain organism more than you could possibly ever use in your normal lifetime. And I said, you know, life is 100% fatal. Yeah. So while you're living this life that God has so generously given you and is extending for you and is providing for you so that you might have this wonderful life that you have, that you may enjoy it to the fullest of your capability, live the life. And maybe just do that whole thing in moderation, like we've always taught and always learned from people who are wise. Everything in moderation, right? Live your life. That's why God gave it to you. God gives life. God doesn't take life. There was a story. I mean, actually, this happened when we were living in Brookings. And Pastor Rhonda Hanisch, and I don't know, you knew Pastor Rhonda, didn't you, from Ascension, or did she leave before? Yeah, okay. A wonderful person, and I don't think she knows, and I hope maybe that I have told her in some words or another before she retired, that she actually gave me words that I really needed and has probably shaped what I hope to give you on some days. She's just really very good, and she knew the right words to say when she needed to say them, and she wasn't afraid to say them, if I remember correctly. There was a young man, a high school student, who died. And I don't remember the circumstances of his death. I believe it was a car accident, but I'm not sure. And the congregation was grieving deeply for the loss of this young man and his family. And Pastor Rhonda did the funeral, and the place was packed. And Pastor Rhonda came up, she started her sermon. And she said, I've heard so many times this past week that God must have needed this young man, and that's why he took him. And Pastor Rhonda went on to say, I don't want to ever hear that again. Not from anybody, because as much as it is meant to give comfort, all it does is give more pain. I'm here to tell you that when this young man died, Jesus wept. God sorrows with us. And if God sorrows with us, if Jesus weeps at the loss of the people that we love, then we cannot believe that at the same time it was God who decided that their life was over. Jesus weeps, not just for Lazarus. Jesus weeps with us at every loss that we incur. God has all the angels he needs. We have all that we need because God has so graciously given it to us so that we might have abundant and beautiful life. You are the child of God.
God, in God's great love and wisdom and grace and mercy, has promised not only abundant life here and now with all of you, with all of us, with all of our family, with the whole world who needs you, but in new life, when there is a new heaven and a new earth, and there will be no more weeping and no more suffering and no more sadness. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. In Christ, you have heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation. We believe in him and are marked with the seal of the promised Holy Spirit. Living together in trust and hope, we confess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Build yourselves up on your most holy faith. Pray in the Holy Spirit. Keep yourselves in the love of God. Look forward to the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ. If anyone is in Christ, there is a new creation. Everything old has passed away. Behold, everything is become new. God has given us the ministry of reconciliation. Therefore, let us be reconciled to God and to one another. Gracious God, have mercy on us. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone. Uphold us by your Spirit, so that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your holy name. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us all our sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen us in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep us in eternal life. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And also with you.
Will you please share a word of peace with each other? We'll receive our offering at this time. Let us pray. God, our Creator, you open wide your hand and satisfy the desire of every living creature. With these gifts, we bless you for your tender nurture and care. Help us to delight in your will and walk in your ways through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. As God's people called to love one another, let us pray for the needs of the church, the human family, and all the world. O God of resurrection, you call us by name and raise us to life. Rouse your church from slumber, where we have held back in fear or shame, unbind us. Embolden us in our proclamation of your good news, that all may know abundant life. Merciful God, receive our prayer. O God of creation, you have founded your world on rivers and seas. Preserve fresh water sources and the creatures who call them home. Heal places of pollution and nourish people of drought. Merciful God, receive our prayer. O God of the earth, you reign over all nations and peoples. Inspire us with wisdom and discernment. May the leaders of the world govern with justice and uphold the dignity of all people. Merciful God, receive our prayer. God of heaven, you make your home among mortals. Come alongside those who weep this day. Befriend all who are lonely. Encourage those in despair and heal any who are suffering, especially those we name in our hearts today. Abide with your faithful ones in love. Merciful God, receive our prayer. O God, who serves, you set before us a feast of rich food. Sustain our ministries of fellowship and hospitality. Strengthen the hands and hearts of all who prepare and serve food for our nourishment. Merciful God, receive our prayer. O God, Alpha and Omega, we give thanks for your faithful ones who are now at peace with you. With all your saints, we praise you, for you have swallowed up death forever. Merciful God, receive our prayer. All these things, and whatever else you see that we need, grant us, O God, for the sake of Christ, who died and rose again, and now lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated. Oh, no, wait. Let us boldly pray the words that our Savior gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. So if you take a really good deep breath, you'll be able to smell the caramel rolls and the cinnamon rolls that were made this morning, but they're not here because there's no fellowship time here. But aren't you hungry? Don't you want one of those? So if you do, you need to go down to the threshing bee and pay a visit to Bethania Brew's booth, which you will find just south of the pie booth. So if you could have pie and then coffee, or you could have pie, coffee, and a caramel roll, or, well, never mind, you do what you want to do. We have egg coffee, iced coffee, coffee with ice cream, which is called affogato, fresh squeezed homemade lemonade, with the lemon right in the lemonade, if that's what you would like, and a fellowship. You know, this is a great place to just go, and all of the proceeds will go to the general fund for the church. So if you just go to the threshing bee, and while you're there, enjoy yourself, have fun, go see what there is about. We have worship at the countryside on this Thursday at 2:30. Everyone is welcome to come and worship with the people at the countryside. We have communion, so you're welcome to come and partake. The new school year starts this Thursday, right? Thursday. Oh, my goodness. It starts Thursday. So next Sunday, at the 9:30 worship, we're going to bless the new school year, the students, the teachers, the staff, anybody that needs to be blessed. Bring your backpacks or whatever it is that you carry back and forth from school to make your life every day make your life better, and we will have a blessing. Fall Festival is September 10th. So please be thinking and praying about how you might use the gifts that God has given you in this abundant life so that you may share them with your community. Of course, there will be a wonderful dinner, as always, and good fellowship. So yeah, please make that a part of your day on September 10th. Prayer concerns or joys for the congregation? Anything to lift up? All right. Any other announcements that I've forgotten about or need to add? Well, then the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God. in Jesus Christ our Lord, and the blessing of the Almighty Lord, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Please stand, and we'll sing our sending song number 744 in the Blue Book. Go in peace. Okay, we will.